July, '27, 2018. The stars out of Buddhist land. What was the answer out of you? It's come to this Chaya meditation on Ashwini. Lunch, dharma, and sangha dharma. Every day, which gives all us robes, ladders. Today is a special day, special event for that reason. According to the lunar calendars, today is the whole moon day of July. There's the Buddha from the fourth level of heaven to see the celestial world and came down in human world, taking the conception in small one. Is today the second one. So is the Buddha about 29 years old. He renounced the world and practiced meditation for 6 years. The day that he renounced the world, this day, Asara Puja, it's the beautiful day of this July. The third one, after the Buddha's face enlightenment, he gives the Dhamma talk. It's the first sermon of the Buddha. It's the day, the full moon day of July. So we have special events take place. One, the day is the conception. The two, he renounced the world. The three, he gives the first sermon. That's why, as the Buddha Puja, Dhamma Puja, Sangha Puja, all of you comes to the temple and the most is done observing Sila and practice meditation bound. Here's what a knowledge. I would like all of you to remember we have 7 days. The day is the Buddha's the conception is mother womb is Thursday. Please remember Thursday. At the day he was born, Friday. Friday. The day he renounced the world is Monday. The day he gains enlightenment, Wednesday. The day he delivers the first sermon, Saturday. After he passed away, the discrimination day is the Sunday. So we have 7 days. Remember? Sunday, discrimination day. Monday, renounce the war. And Tuesday, the day he passed away. Tuesday, the day he passed away. Wednesday, the day he gains enlightenment. Thursday is the conception is not a womb. The Friday he was born. Saturday he gives the first sermon. So 7 days for the Buddhist people, we need to remember that. And especially when he gives the first sermon, Dhamma Jaka Bodhana Sutra, the Buddha say about the Four Noble Truths. The Four Noble Truths. Number one, delivered from suffering. The second one, delivered from the cause of suffering. The third one, the noble truth of the cessation of suffering. Number four is that the noble truth to lead the cessation of suffering. Buddha is very about his four noble truths. All the Buddha's teaching during 45 years is consistent with his four noble truths. The first one, the noble truth of suffering. So we need to know, understand the suffering. To be able to understand suffering, we need to practice meditation. So the Buddha is thinking about this suffering. We have 13 kinds of suffering. We suffer every day. You know, just the first one, just the birth is suffering. We stay our mother womb 9 months, 10 months, suffering, but we don't remember. We don't realize that. That's why someone still want to be reborn again, right? So it's suffering, birth is suffering. And decay is suffering. We getting old, older and older, every moment, every second. No one can stop it. Even you sleep well, you enjoy, you know, your seeing, hearing, smelling, tasting, touching, thinking. When you are happy, it's getting older every moment, every second. No one wants to get old. But as the universal law, the law of the Dharma, we are getting older and older every second. It's the decay is suffering. And disease is suffering. So everyone has now more and less diseases. So no one wants to have this all kind of diseases. What we have to face. That's why this disease is suffering. When it has come in, we have to depart from this world, say goodbye from our dear one. No one wants to depart from the one and new one. But each time coming, we have to go. That's why death is suffering. And sometimes in our life, we have to depart from our dear one, the one we love, the thing we love, the place we love. So we have to depart from just our, just the dear one. Is suffering. Sometimes we have associates with the one we don't want to live with, but we have to. The suffering. And sometimes we cannot get the one you want. The suffering. You want something, you get another. One you get, you don't like it. The one you don't, you like, you cannot get it. This one kind of suffering. See that? One kind of suffering. Now sometimes we have to worry about something, sorry about something, forget about our business, our health, our families, our society, and so on. The sorrow is one kind of suffering. So feel sorry a lot, what happened? Sorrow is the one kind of fire. So burning our heart, and then you cry. this lamentation, crying, is the one kind of suffering. Now in our daily life, this on every day, we have the physical painful feeling. That's why we have to move in all the time. You cannot sit still. Why? Suffering. Especially if you have some kind of disease. To suffer a lot. And you cannot get up easily. You cannot sit down easily. You cannot walk easily. Just the physical suffering. And also we have mental suffering. Mental suffering. So we have to deal about, worry about, sorry about so many kind of things in our life. Just the mental suffering. Sometimes a lot of difficulty you have encounters. We call despair. You don't want to live in the human world anymore. Because hurt a lot, suffer a lot. Because despair always is one kind of suffering. So many kinds of suffering. When does suffering come from? Because we have to suffer by aggregates, mind and body. Mind and body. As you have body, you have suffer from your body. As we have mind, we have to suffer about our mind. Because this mind and body as the main cause. It's still about when we get up in the morning, what do we have to do? Rush to the restroom. See that? Maybe someone doesn't think that it's the suffering. This suffering every day, the rest of our life. We have to go to the restroom, we have to go to our showroom, have brush our face, wash our face, see that, change our clothes, have to drink something, eat something. It's not only one day, one month, one year, the rest of our life. This one kind of suffering, because we have to mind and body. See that? That's why the Buddha says many kind of suffering. It's the noble truth of suffering. Why we call the noble? We need to understand why we call this suffering, why we call the noble truth of suffering. In a Pali term, we call Arya Dukkha Satya. Arya is noble. Dukkha is suffering. Satya is the truth. So the noble truth of suffering. This suffering discovered by the Buddha. The noble is a noble. This the Buddha is noble one. He discovered that. That's what we call the noble truth of suffering. And also who practice meditation and gains enlightenment. We understand this truth. That's why we call the noble truth of suffering. For anyone who practices meditation, can become the noble one. That's why we call the noble truth of suffering. You see, this is the phenomenon of this suffering. Where does suffering come from? It's not someone created. In Buddhism, no creator, no super being this world creates this suffering, creates the being. This the suffering always come from because the noble truth the cause of suffering because of our attachment. Because of our attachment. In previous life, we attached to this world, this sensual pleasure, sensuous object as it, why we attach to this attachment, because we don't understand the truth. Avijja, ignorance. Ignorance. As we cannot see the truth, we attach to it. So, later on, our attachment becomes bigger and bigger, and become because the more attachment. Upadana. There's more attachment, what do we do? We do something, karma, action, arise. This action of physical action, verbal action, mental action. Sometimes we do good thing to good action. Sometimes a bad action. That's because of this avijja, ignorance. Because of this dana craving, upadana attachment, karma action. It's the four causes. As the cause of suffering. Then we become as human beings. In the law of dependent origination, we call avijja paccaya sankhara paccaya vijnana. Because of this karma, action, vijnana, rebirth consciousness takes place. Have you done a good action? We be as human being. Some become celestial being. If you do some unwholesome action, so this vijnana, rebirth consciousness will take place in unhappy state, become as animal, hungry ghost, demon, hell being. So depend on this causes. So maybe as human being, or celestial being, or Brahma, or this being in unhappy state, depend on our action, not depend on anyone, no creator. So we need to understand this point. So the Buddha said, this, the cause of suffering is the attachment. It's no attachment. You reach the same suffering. How to reduce and remove our attachment? We need to practice meditation. We need to practice meditation. How to practice meditation? The Buddha says, the way to lead to the cessation of suffering, we have to follow the Noble Eightfold Path. Right understanding, right thinking, right speech, right action. Right life to you, right effort, right mindfulness, right concentration. This is the Noble Eightfold Path. This Noble Eightfold Path is to briefly consist into sila, samadhi, vajra. That's why we need to have this morality, sila. Try to restrain our physical and verbal action. May our sila become pure. It's necessary as a foundation of this to attain the enlightenment, the cessation of suffering. Number two, samadhi, concentration. Mind as Aranyan is monkey mind. It's like monkey jumping, running all the time. So, if our mind still wanders a lot, you will not gain concentration, no wisdom will arise. That's why that's our wisdom to arise, we need concentration. That's why we practice tranquility meditation, vipassana meditation, try to great concentration. Use our effort, use our mindfulness and concentration. As you have the sila, pure, calm, you practice meditation, you gain concentration, and wisdom will arise. Wisdom here is to see the phenomena of this mind and body, what is really are. As all that you know, you will see three characteristics of this mind and matter: as impermanent, as the suffering, as non-self nature. When you see the three characteristics of this mind and matter, you can reduce your attachment for sure, little by little. So keep practice. Finally, you can remove your attachment. If no attachment, this means Nirodha. Nirodha is no mental defilement, no suffering. And then, please, Nirodha, you will experience. For example, we practice meditation for 1 minute. You gain concentration for 1 minute, keep practice meditation, no attachment, no mental defilement, presence. I feel happy, sukha, this nirodha, no attachment, no mental defilement, no greed and no delusion, no suffering. This nirodha is the main, we have to experience this next life, here and now, as you practice meditation. You experience this, the noble truth, cessation of suffering. Even we got Dhamma Nirodha, this the temporary Nirodha, Sukha. So, mainly what we have to do, practice. The way lead the cessation of suffering, this Vipassana method. Vipassana, our mindfulness meditation, our Vipassana, whatever we call it, the synonym. We can call Vipassana meditation, the mindfulness meditation. So keep practice meditation, you will see the truth. As you see the suffering, you will be able to eliminate the cause of suffering, attachment. As you be able to reduce and remove attachment, you will gain peace and happiness, Nirodha. So I would all of you, today as the special day in Buddhism, try to follow the guidance of the Buddha. You know, try to follow the Noble Eightfold Path, having Sila, Samadhi, Banya. There you understand the truth and eliminate cause of suffering, attachment, and gain enlightenment in this way of life. Thank you for your attention.